And this is the history of.
The one who's talking about original hot boy. The turf won't in, run up and get shot, boy.
Series.
$1 billion ambition.
Cash Money aren't without their own rising star. Turk, better known as one of the hot boys, is currently working on his first solo venture.
On a Vlad interview, Turk talks about Juvenile saying, "Get it how you live" was better than guerrilla warfare.
Fatigued up, full of that dope, ready for war. Me and Mark with K's, hanging station up, banging a kill, shooting at anything that's chilling with 100 rounds, so you know it's gonna be a killing.
But Turk disagrees because he feels on guerrilla warfare he was coming out of his shell.
Hot boys, we on fire. They don't got a nigga who could outshine us. Cash Money records really be nothing nice. The Rolex be whirling, full of ice. We get our spark on nigga through the week. Me, Wayne, Juvie, and the BG.
Meaning he started getting better.
I like them hot, the ones that don't tell me to stop. Eat it up, swallow them, and they know how to pop. I need a project chick, a hood rat chick, one that don't really care since she took that stick.
Juvenile liked Turk's verse on I Need a Hot Girl so much that he made that a hook for the song Project Chick. Turk explains that he didn't see his verse becoming legendary, let alone the song becoming a hit. He called his style of simplicity keeping it young and thuggin'.
But the 99 in the 2000.
To name a few highlights for Turk in 99, when Cash Money first took over the game, Chopper City in the Ghetto by BG. He appeared on the track Knockout with Juvenile.
In the legs, we getting blunted, fucking hoes and count money. Niggas bought anything, he bustin' and rap lustin'. Two niggas that 17, playin' with kid nigga. Nigga disrespect my mind, look, we pullin' triggers.
Also, he appeared on Lil Wayne's The Block Is Hot debut album. On the track, you want war.
Red on wall, nigga, let's be. Do it how you wanna, take it to the streets. I breathe, I'm a camera, lost reeds on my feet. Through your end like your end, leave it burning like heat. What you ain't know, I'm the one from the TC. Chop a shooter, black rules out that MAG.
Then in the year 2000, Cash Money released a movie called Baller Blocking. From the self-titled song, from the soundtrack, Turk stars the music video.
Sundown, get our grind on. Tryna bust it wide open and build up my claim. Send a hit at this so we can be the jank. You know how it is, want everything for my.
The song is featured by E-40.
Believe it, playboy.
Why you blocking us? Baller blocking us. You keep trying, ain't no stopping us. Why you blocking us? Baller blocking us.
Slick slide, slippery like you. PHI being on the. Call the police on a young ball player trying to money Mac up on a million. The game, I get your.
Also in the year of 2000, Cash Money and Rough Riders had a tour.
Welcome back to 1515. This tour represents different things to different members of the Cash Money and Rough Riders camps. But to Cash Money's Young Turk and Rough Rider Dragon, each of whom appeared on other artists' records but have never dropped albums of their own, it represents a chance for the audience to get to know them just a little bit better.
All of Cash Money artists were going platinum. Juvenile with the 400 Degrees, Hot Boys with Guerrilla Warfare, BG with Chopper City in the Ghetto, Lil Wayne with The Block Is Hot. Cash Money took over the game.
Hot Boys, Hot Boys, Hot Boys.
I just love them all. Bling, bling.
DMX was the only platinum artist on Rough Riders, but went platinum twice with two albums in the same year in 98.
He was the first dude to drop two albums that both went platinum in the same year.
The first S.
How the fuck did that happen? Bring us through that.
What happened was, by the time I got my deal, I felt like I was vindicated. I was like, yes, finally.
That's a big word.
Finally, I felt like it was owed to me.
Uh-huh.
Big mistake on my behalf, but that's another story. But an offer was made to me that if I could, after I dropped my first album, an offer was made to me that if I was able to drop another album or record another album within 30 days, then I'd get $1 million.
This is your first time having a million, correct?
First time I was offered $1 million.
Offered $1 million. Yeah. That's hard.
I didn't have $1 million, by then. I mean, okay, like I said, I was about two albums at the same time.
So now what was the first album? What was the name of it again?
It's Dark and Hell Is Hot.
And then
It's Dark and Hell Is Hot.
With Flesh of
My Flesh,
album.
Blood of My Blood.
Flesh of My
then
Flesh.
There was X. Got niggas like, what's next? And getting Great Depression, Grand Chance,
get a dog again.
I've been wondering about when your record's gonna drop. Do you have? Is there a date yet?
It ain't no date yet, but it's an effect, Young and Thuggin'. You heard me? Be out in a minute.
Young and Thuggin' is the debut album by New Orleans rapper Turk, released on June 5th, 2001. Through Cash Money Records and produced entirely by Manny Fresh.
Come on, look. When I start to spree, clear the way, I get knocked. Cause once my thing cock, I didn't aim and pop. I'm a donkey woolly, a untamed gorilla. Wilder than Willa, TC representer. Known for spinning bins, beating about 50. Plus I'm quick to ride and give it to your snitches. I'm a low down fella, always have, always will. Uptown fella, young and thuggin', plus I'm real. In my blood and my veins, to be the way that I be. All I know is killing, murder, drama, no peace. Youngster, 19, who got off the porch early. I done did it all, believe that you heard me. Rubber like testing, look, don't you do it. Cause I don't hesitate, especially if you blew it. You said I run through it like a madman. Don't think I won't do it, leave your mama sad, man.
Now you gotta understand, Wayne, BG, and Juvie, them niggas were rappers. Nigga, I was just a football player, just fucking with that shit. So them niggas kind of like groomed me, dawg, you know what I'm saying? That's why a nigga always be like, Turk was the weakest hot boy, and you know what I'm saying? Which I don't know, I'm, nigga, I'm on about 200-300 songs, you feel me? Mm-hmm. But I didn't realize who the fuck a nigga was, dawg, till a nigga went to prison, nigga, goddamn. I got 22 years now, nigga talking about, nigga, you my favorite. I used to want to be you. Damn, nigga, why y'all ain't been tell me that shit? You feel me? Nigga, I probably wouldn't be in this motherfucker with y'all, you feel me? But you know, I didn't know, dawg, I was still in the streets. You know, still drugging and thugging, going hard. Like, you know, riding around with choppers. My niggas probably just robbed a nigga, and I never abandoned my niggas, you feel me? Until I had to realize, man, I gotta let y'all nigga go, nigga. If y'all
That's
love me, y'all gonna understand. And now I'm at that age where some of my nigga mad at me because they don't understand. Nigga, I got a family now. You know what I'm saying? There's a difference. And plus, when I was in penitentiary, you nigga wasn't there, nigga, like Imani. You feel me? So yeah, I woke up.
I was gonna say,
yeah. Tell me about growing up in New Orleans.
I mean, you know, like any other poverty-stricken community, you know, I'm from the Magnolia, born in the Melfamine.
Gus, AKA Melfamine.
But I moved out when I was a youngster, like probably 5 years old, and I moved to the Magnolia, and I grew up in the Magnolia. You know what I'm saying?
Magnolia bread.
Hot the Magnolia to the bone. Hot boy Turk.
And that's where I kind of like got my training at, man. I went from being a troop to a soldier, you know. Went through a whole lot of stuff, you feel me? From, you know, we wasn't into no gang banging or nothing. It's like more of sets, cutthroat type, you know what I'm saying, situations, every man for himself. But we did have wards. Like, I was from the third ward. You know what I'm saying? You had the Calio, which was the third wall.
1970s, the atmosphere began to change. The rise of violent crimes and murder was becoming the new face of the Calio, and that was just the beginning. In 1994, the Calio was documented as the bloodiest project in all of the United States.
And if a lived past 94 and it was on the street, a gangster, fuck all that.
Man, what the fuck you talking about? If a lived past 94 and it was out here off the porch, a gangster. It was rereaded and weak, nigga. Okay. You understand? I wrote it a quarter, nigga. I'm telling you, if a nigga left past 94, that was the worst year. That was the worst year. And I was out here snowing, running like a big dog opposed to. You understand what I'm saying? You know, it wasn't a thing to do, but that was what I was doing at the time, you know? Yeah.
They was up the street, then we had the Melfamine, what was the third ward.
We're the Melfamine Project right now.
They was back the street, you know what I'm saying? Then you had the Magnolia right here, so you got all three of these, and they all gangsters, you know what I'm saying? We all uptown, you feel me? So it was like You already know, man, it was a lot of war, man. Like, a lot of shootouts, you know, a lot of beef that's still going on to this day, and it'll never stop. It ain't gonna never stop, you know what I'm saying? Politics couldn't stop it, you feel me? That's the type of beef that go on.
Because this man dead killed that man dead.
Yeah, it's like generation, like it passed down, like it'll never stop. It might die down a little bit, but it ain't gonna never stop, you feel me?
You know, New Orleans, on the outside looking in, is a beautiful city. People come there for tourists, you know, for vacations.
On Bourbon Street.
Bourbon Street, of course, right? Yeah. You know what I'm saying? But yeah. You take a couple of...
Even Bourbon Street now, they've been doing a lot of shooting on Bourbon Street lately, man. You know, so I think it's just violence everywhere, man. Like, you know, everybody experience it, you know what I'm saying? And I think, like, when the media get involved and they put the news cameras on it, they shed light on certain places more than the other. Wherever they pushing the next motive of the election, you feel me? They gonna focus on it. But it's going on anywhere where it's poverty, you know what I'm saying? It's going on, man, because it's a dog-eat-dog community, you know what I'm saying? And everybody feel like it's not enough out there. So anybody who get a hold of something, the next person, he don't understand that he could get the same thing. He trying to take what he got, you feel me? So it become like a struggle for, you know what I'm saying? Wow. Who gonna be the man, you know, who gonna be number one? And I realized, damn, my story is the glory, you feel me? And I just start telling my story.
The divine interpretation of my life says that I've seen the passion of Christ went from millions in record sales.
Rap wound up being, you know what I'm saying, my way out the hood, you feel me? Until shit started being the way it was.
So basically, goddamn, coming from New Orleans, like, Baby Them was always the it. Like, we can get up with them niggas, we gonna get on.
Man, being with Stunning Them was like, let me see, like Russell Simmons them, like Suge was on the West Coast, you know what I'm saying? Like Puffy, you know. If you got with Cash Money, dawg, like, your life instantly changed.
That's like, you know, Mickey being with Disney.
Instantly.
To a consumer drug sale.
Man, I used to love Heron, bro. Like, it wasn't nothing that could have took the place of that, you know? Mm. And I was snorting at first. Mm. And eventually, you graduate.
Seeing loved ones die while in jail. Know how it feel to have a child that you barely held.
I love my babies. I also have a 14-year-old son, you know, spent summer with him, so.
I feel when death on your trail. Now I know how I feel to prevail. Now I know how I feel when God take your eyes and remove the scales. I've been on a journey, but I realize life just alone. Sometimes to see the hearts of men, God put you alone. I'm still thugging through the microphone. Taking hardship, using God's gifts. In spite of negative tones, got this YNT vision that gotta be fulfilled. Like the 22 years got overturned on the field. So miss me with that fake shit, cause I detect it. I thank God for my experience for living reckless.
Reckless, cause my movie, like the modern day Ray Charles movie, you know what I'm saying? It's just crazy, man. My life a movie.